How's it going, everyone? My name is Alexis and I work for the SRC, specifically for the rock. That is the rock wall and the bouldering wall there, where you see all the people rock climbing all the time. And we wanted to make a quick little guide or a quick little crash course of how to pick shoes and maybe deciding what shoes would be best for you depending on your performance and your experience climbing. So in order to do that, we need to look at some criteria and things to look for. So these things are going to be the shoe type or the shape of the shoe, which would either be neutral, moderate, or aggressive. The closure system, which will either be laced, Velcro, or slip-on. The types of rubber compounds that there are. The uppers in which the material the shoe is actually made of. And your personal foot size and shape. So with that being said, we're going to go ahead and take a look at these shoe types now. So now we're going to be looking at the different shapes of shoes or the different shoe types. And the first one is going to be a neutral shape. And these are geared more towards beginners because of their overall comfort that they offer. As you can see from all these images here, they have a relatively flat profile when it comes to the rubber sole, which allows for good support all throughout the foot, evenly distributed, especially when you're climbing just vertically, getting started with your climbing. A good beginner shoe is very important because it allows you to focus more on your technique and less on your feet hurting all the time because you're wearing something that's maybe a little too tight for you. As you can see on the bottom left here, we do have the 510 Gym Masters, which are actually the shoes that we rent out to the patrons that want to go climb at the rock for the first time. So if you ever want to check out the rock and you don't have shoes, you don't have to worry about that. You can always rent them for free. Just ask anybody working at the desk there and they'll be happy to help you. Now the next type of shoes are going to be moderate shoes. So this is a shoe that's a little more downturn, as you can see in some of these images right here. Definitely more turn in the toe area. Definitely serve an all-purpose, all-around use if you're maybe starting to get something that will work for you on most big wall climbs or work with you on most bouldering routes. This is something that can and will work for you. I personally do have the Anasazi Lace, and they're my go-to shoe when it comes to doing anything on a longer route, maybe on like the top rope, maybe on a sport climbing route. But it can also serve use on anything that's a boulder. Really, you don't need to look for something more aggressive unless you're maybe going to something that's a little more of a steep route, which is where these guys come into play. And so this is definitely a big purchase and a big step when it comes to your climbing collection of shoes or your collection of equipment, because these are the most aggressive shoes you can get. Obviously, there's more of a downturn in these compared to all the other shoes. The heel tension is definitely a little tighter on these because you definitely want to be able to use your heel for a heel hook. As you can see, there are different types of rubbers on the heel, which is something that you can also look at, which is an important factor when it comes to deciding what kind of shoe you want, depending on the performance that you're trying to get out of the shoe. They are generally a little less comfortable because they really, really allow your toes to become packed. So they're definitely not something you're going to be wearing all day unless you have the pain tolerance of somebody that feels absolutely no pain. But I wanted to bring some attention really quick to the soles of some of these shoes. As you can see, the Solution does have a split sole, which allows the shoe to be a little more flexible, a little more sensitive when it comes to maybe climbing something that's a little more downturn. You don't necessarily need as much support as something as moderate because you're not necessarily going to always be climbing up a vertical wall. So that's definitely a factor that should be considered when buying a shoe. So now we're going to be looking at some of the closure systems. And the first one we're going to be touching on are going to be the laced shoes. So a big benefit about these shoes is that they are versatile in the way that you can fit them. If you maybe wanted a little more tension in the toe area, or if you maybe wanted to have a little bit of a looser fit just because you're warming up or you're warming into the shoe, you could definitely do that because these shoes allow you to really, really have that custom fit. They're definitely more geared towards people that are trying to keep their shoes on for longer periods of time. So maybe people that are more interested in sport climbing or just top rope climbing, because the shoes are going to be on your feet for a while, and you definitely something that you should be aware of. They're not the easiest shoes to take off, because they are going to be tied. So that's definitely something that you should take into account when looking into getting these shoes. I personally had the 510 Rogue Laces as my very first pair of shoes. I really enjoyed them. I would recommend them to any person that's trying to get into climbing. But as you can see, there are definitely plenty of aggressive options as well for people that are looking to have that fit with the laces, but are maybe trying to look for something a little more aggressive. Then we have the Velcro closure system, which a big selling point for these is that they are very easy to take on and off. They do have the convenience of doing that at a lot faster rate than the laced shoes. And because of that, you'll find this closure system on stuff that's more aggressive, stuff that you don't want to keep on your feet for so long because they can hurt after quite a while. But you will also find them on plenty of moderate shoes like this Anasazi Pro, which is actually a very popular bouldering shoe, despite it not having the most aggressive downturn on its sole. But maybe some of the cons of these kinds of shoes is that you won't have the most custom fit compared to something that has laces. But plenty of different shoes offer different kinds of closure systems with the Velcro. As you see, you have three different Velcro straps here, three different Velcro straps here, with just one on this shoe and two. So there's definitely plenty of options to look at. And the last one that we're going to be discussing are going to be the slip-on and the slipper shoes. So these are very popular amongst a lot of climbers just because they have a sleek design. They're very easy to put on, very easy to take off, and they actually surprisingly do a very good job of keeping your feet compact for however long you're going to be using the shoe. And a very big misconception when it comes to these kinds of shoes is that you're only going to find them on stuff that's a little more neutral, a little more moderate, like the 510 Moccasin or the Evolve Addicts. But there are plenty of slip-on shoes that are pretty aggressive, like the Boreal Ninja and the La Sportiva Cobra. These are definitely not shoes that you would offer to a beginner, but they do have the convenience of being a slip-on shoe. A con of these shoes is that since they don't have a closure system that you can obviously redo a lot, they can stretch over time. But the elastic here on the front of the shoe has definitely shown to last pretty long. So yeah, very popular option. That definitely something you should look at as well. Okay, so now we're going to be looking at different rubber compounds, and we're only going to be focusing on two specific compounds for the purpose of this video. And the first one is going to be the Stealth rubber from 510. And they have three main compounds. The Stealth C4 is what you're going to find on mostly all of their soles. It's their signature rubber compound. They've used it for a long time, plenty of years. Definitely known for its stickiness, definitely known for its ability to edge very well. And then they have other rubber compounds such as their MI6, which is just a toe patch for most of their shoes that have toe patches. So, obviously anything that you're going to be doing toe hooks for definitely helps with cushioning those toes, making sure they're not getting completely crushed by the rocks. Obviously very beneficial for people that are maybe looking to boulder some harder routes as they go on. And then they have the HF compound, which they don't use in a lot of shoes. It's actually one of their most sensitive compounds. You'll find them on some of their more aggressive models, like the 510 Dragon, which is actually the shoe in this picture. So that's definitely something that you can look at if you're really focusing on that sensitivity, really trying to focus on how that rock feels on the wall under your feet precisely for the purpose of precision. Now we're going to focus on a Vibram rubber, which actually is kind of used between a bunch of different brands. They don't make their own shoes, but they sell their compound and they work with other brands to find the perfect use of the rubber depending on the shoe that the brand's trying to make. XS Grip is pretty much the staple of what the rubbers that they produce are. Definitely focused on their ability, overall balance in terms of performance. The XS Grip 2 is definitely focused more on precision, a little more sensitive than the XS Grip. As you can see, it's going to be on the solution, geared more towards having more precision where you're trying to put your feet. And recommended more for people that want to really go outside, really try and get their hands on some real rock, go do some outdoor climbing. And then you have the XS Edge, which is definitely a little more durable than the XS Grip 2. In terms of sensitivity, it's not going to be as sensitive, but it does offer good support for some of the smaller edges. As you can see, it's in the name XS Edge. But yes, this is an important thing to look at as you go along in your climbing. Different rubber compounds can offer different benefits. There are plenty of other rubber compounds. I just wanted to narrow down to the two main ones that I personally see people using, which would be obviously the Stealth rubber and the Vibram rubber. Great, so we're going to be looking at the two main materials that uppers are made of, and the upper is pretty much what the word says. It's just the top part of the shoe right here, what the shoe is actually made of. And they can either be made of leather and suede materials, or they can be made out of a synthetic material. And the thing about leather and suede shoes is that they do have a break-in period. You definitely want to downsize the shoes compared to the regular street shoe size that you wear, because after a while they are going to mold to your feet, which will lead to a more custom fit, which a lot of people favor. They're definitely more breathable in terms of obviously letting sweat and stuff kind of escape the shoe. They're definitely won't smell as bad as a synthetic shoe after a while. But because of the malleable nature of leather and suede, after a while they can lose their original shape. But if you're more concerned about the fit being a little more comfortable, a little more meant specifically for your feet, then leather and suede is definitely a good option. It's actually one of the options that most climbers use. But there are synthetic uppers, which out of the box, you probably don't want to downsize too much, because the thing about these shoes is that they're not going to stretch as much as a leather and suede shoe. They do last a very long time because of that. Their shape is pretty true to itself for most of the shoe's life. But the only issue with that is that they don't ever really truly mold to your feet the way that a leather and suede shoe would. So just to kind of get all those details together here, a leather and suede shoe, you definitely want to downsize because it will stretch over time. A synthetic shoe, you probably don't want to do as much downsizing or any at all, because the shoe will stay that shape. And I actually included two of the same exact shoes, the high angle made by 510. Obviously, this is the leather one and this is the synthetic one. Same exact shoe, just different materials, obviously just depending on what people prefer. But that's also something that you can take into account when looking to buy shoes. Great, so the last big detail or the last big factor that I wanted to touch on is the shape of your foot. So this really does matter when it comes to picking a shoe, because you definitely want a shoe that's not going to have too much dead space, too much space between the foot and the actual shoe. That can lead to injuries along the way. And you definitely don't want something that's too, obviously closed or too tight onto your feet, because that could lead to other kinds of issues. So you really want to find a shoe that works best for you. So obviously someone with a narrow foot is going to want something that's a little more narrow, like the La Sportiva Katana. Someone with a medium foot, which, you know, the average person is going to have, which most climbing shoes are actually going to be geared to this foot style, obviously, because, like I said, most people have it. So you won't have an issue really finding shoes that work for you, but the La Sportiva Squama is definitely a good example of a shoe that would work. But for us folk that have a wider foot, like myself personally, something like the La Sportiva Mira, something with the toe box that has a wide enough profile for you to really get a comfortable fit but a compact fit, is going to work best for you. I personally have the 510 Aliens, or the Allions, and they work really well. I have a pretty wide foot myself, so I would recommend those to anybody. So you definitely don't want to disregard sizing a shoe, and if you can try the shoes on in person, that is the best way to go. If you can't, I really strongly urge that you look into how people size specific shoes, because different shoes are sized differently. I know certain stores and certain brands definitely allow you to return the shoe within like 30 days. Other places aren't as, you know, lenient. So definitely look into return policies. I'll definitely be including some links at the end of the video, just to make sure that I can offer you a reliable source for a place to get good shoes. But yeah, I just want to touch on this one more time, because it's very, very important for you to get shoes that fit you the way that you need them to fit them. So yeah, don't overlook this detail. To wrap up the video, I just wanted to include all the links from all the places that I found obviously all the shoes at. Adidas Outdoor, which is going to be 510, Black Diamond, Evolve, Scarpa, La Sportiva. So those are the main shoe brands that I focused on in this video. There are plenty of other brands, as you'll see when you look out and buy different products. I've also included links to some of the best places to get these shoes. REI is definitely a good place, a good local place as well. You can go try on shoes. Backcountry always has sales going on. Epic TV also has plenty of sales going on. If you kind of already know what you're looking for, those are great places to check. And again, this is just a very brief explanation of shoes. There's a lot more that goes into them, but hopefully this will just give you an idea of what you should be looking for and things that really matter when it comes to looking at shoes. So thank you for spending this time listening to me ramble about shoes, and if you have any questions, feel free to ask anyone at the Rock, anyone that, you know, rock climbs there all the time. Plenty of great people. And if you want us to review any other products, please let us know. So yeah, have a good day.